Hey everybody, it's 40 Warrior, welcome back to X-Men Legends. The last time, two brothers and a killing machine went into a bar and drank a ton of Molson. One had too many Molson and needed to be beaten down, while the other one never gets drunk, and the other one is too straight-laced and only had one drink. Nah, actually, we just found these two rapscallions lying around to find each other, and yeah. So in this part, we're gonna continue on. What, you expect me to say exactly what we're gonna do? I barely even know what I'm doing right now. I thought you guys knew that already!
You're going down.
Screw off, buddy. And I see the skirmishers are very happy to see me again. Oh wow, I shot from- He slid through the door at 1 mile an hour! He slid through the door at 1 mile an hour! What is he weigh like eight? What is he weigh a car? And Havoc, did you really do anything there or no?
Combo!
There's that bleed kill. Did Havoc really do anything there? I saw him attack, but I don't think it did anything, to be honest. And I can't go through this, huh? Well, pointless force field then is pointless, I guess. So, we have learned one thing already this game. It's possible to whoa! How do we get up there? Come on, Wolverine! Yes! I'll take the sketchbook. You can screw off. I'm probably sure I could probably get up there. Hello, Porky Pig. Nice to meet you too.
Guess you didn't want a piece of me.
Ooh, prisoner. Going up. I can't reach.
Heads up, people.
So I can't do anything for you, but apparently I have to rescue some prisoners now. Well, that's wonderful because you know this place is full of sickos. This guy is physical resistant. Yep, I thought so.
I'm on it.
456 damage to the win and a DNA generator. Thank you.
I don't have enough.
Oh, great. Did I get hit by one of those stupid energy drainers? Because that makes me upset. That makes me very, very sad. That basic DNA generator, wonderful. It seems like I gotta get up there to those controls. That should be too bad. Oh, jeez! And wouldn't you know it, there is one of these goddamn things, so it needs to be destroyed right now. No questions asked. Why beat the shit out of you? Do 83 damage in one swing for some unknown reason. And is Havoc still doing anything? I don't even know. Physical resistance.
Yes.
Hey! What'd you do that for? I just killed him by accident! Yes!
We got incoming!
Did that seriously just happen? I just killed him without trying. If this is the type of episode I'm gonna have, then I'm gonna love it. Like, seriously. I'm gonna be smiling from ear to ear at this rate. Get on my face, buddy. You can screw off. Oh, jeez. Screw Skirmisher. And yes!
Sorry about that.
If you can't tell, I'm kind of excited about the fact that I get to actually record for once in a while. I have a day off right now, so. The one advantage about just starting out is they're not going to give you stuff to do without somebody to actually, you know, teach you.
Right.
Which proves to be very awesome. And the fact that a bunch of them are out doing, you know, auditing stuff means nobody's gonna be in the office.
I need more power to do
so
that.
I wouldn't be able to do shit. So they said, you know what, don't bother coming in.
Sweet dream sucker.
That's the big challenge with interning is, trying to get the person involved really quickly. And, you know, make it feel you're doing something. Oh, thanks. So you do have some use, Havoc. I can't go through here yet. That's the way out. And I'm pretty sure something else I need to do. And having that it feels good to have an internship now. It really does. I feel a little more involved. I haven't had too many dull moments. And hopefully I won't. It sounds like I won't. It's a small firm, so. Ooh, nice. And double nice. Warlocks.
Thank you. Thank you. I was the next on the test list.
What's going on here?
They're experimenting on us. On mutants. They treat us like lab rats.
Who's doing this? Department H? Canadian Secret Service?
No, I'm pretty sure the general is American. Part of something called Operation Vigilance.
What general?
General Kincaid.
Figures.
He's the cold-blooded monster in charge of this slaughterhouse. He called mutants a plague. Said he was gonna make sure we never threatened the security of mankind again.
Where's Kincaid now?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just glad he left. Oh, the horrors I've seen that man commit.
Don't worry, it's over now. You're free.
Nice, another level up.
Ooh yeah, ain't no one standing in my way.
I know how to destroy this. Is you guys gonna wonder what's through the store, and I think it's just the sketchbook thing I went through. And the answer is yes, it was. So, wonderful news, I'm at level 22 with Wolverine, and I'm at level 22 with Cyclops.
All right.
Okay. And I can actually leave this place. This took me an unusually long time to figure out before, and so I'm kind of glad it didn't take me this long to do this time.
Let's head back to the mansion. We have to tell Professor X about this Operation Vigilance program.
I'm not going with you.
Why? Because you're part of the Brotherhood?
You really should listen to what Magneto has to say, Scott. He intends to get mutants the respect they deserve.
Magneto's a violent man, Alex. Do you realize that if Colossus hadn't been there, the nuke plant you and your friends visited would have had a meltdown? Thousands of people would have died. Think that would have gotten you respect?
I didn't know the reactor had been damaged. No. This is war. A war for our freedom. Magneto said people would have to die before it was over. And you're never gonna understand. Goodbye, Scott.
Let him go, Psyche. Let him go.
Well, so much for that, but a mission complete, so I guess some stuff was done. Now, this is where you can go to the next area. Right then and there, because they have to do those two missions at once, as you recall, this and the astral plane. The astral plane's gonna be kind of interesting. It's kind of cool, kind of creepy. I kind of like it though, to be honest.
I call this meeting to inform you that several of us will be taking a trip to the astral plane shortly.
Several? But Charles, I only see you and Jean.
I will be joining them.
Cool! The White Queen is here! It figures they'd call in another super telepath to join the group.
But what is the astral plane?
It's a dimension of the mind. One where thoughts become reality.
Why are you going to the astral plane, Professor?
I'll let Moira answer that question.
X-Men, I believe we've discovered the cause of Ileana's coma.
You have? Tell me, Doctor, quickly!
Her mind no longer inhabits her body, Colossus.
We believe Ileana is on the astral plane.
But she has no psychic powers. How can this be?
I agree, Colossus. It is very strange indeed. And that is the reason Jean, Emma, and I are going to investigate the astral plane. In my absence, Scott will be in charge should any trouble.
Yeah, that was not me, by the way. That was definitely the game going on hyperdrive. When It's, No, I got both. It went ludicrous speed! While the dialogue only went at, very, very fast speed. At Whoa Nelly type speed.
I can feel Ileana's mind is here.
Me too. She's definitely on the astral plane. This doesn't make sense. How could a non-telepathic mutant become trapped on the astral plane?
I don't know, but be vigilant, my friends. This is highly unusual.
Now, first thing we're gonna do, you see we got Professor X now as a character, and he's at level 40. Oh, jeez. I don't know why they have to change team here, because as far as I know, you can only bring psychic people to the party. So, what is the point?
Emma Frost.
She's just kind of like an assassin in that skin.
Emma Frost.
But anyway, Jean Grey's a little 20, and I gotta do a lot of stuff, so. Oh, man. Look at the damage this is going to do. Take it out of here and throw it into here. Nice. Oh, my God. This is going to be unreal. Wait a minute. Can you save these? And you get to see Emma Frost. Now, Emma Frost is kind of odd. Well, you figure she's focused, and, well, she is. Focus girl through and through. Now, like Jean Grey, she can do more damage with her psychic attacks, which is awesome. Now, the thing is, this is what makes her a little limited. She has no real attacks except for psychic bedlam. I wonder what this does. That's actually not that bad, you know, if you think about it. She can turn into a shell, which makes her pretty, tough. But the thing is, you really don't want to go with both the Confuse and Fear. You want to at least do, like, one of them. And you upgrade, you can convert somebody. But if you do Fear, they run away from you. Which is pretty helpful in a crowd control environment. But this is also pretty good. Pretty good. If you can convert enemies. Last time I went with Confuse, it was pretty good. I'm going to go with Fear this time. Which gives you... Oh, it does damage. That's pretty cool. Like I said, I really don't know what I want to do with this route, but... I want to at least give him Frost some sort of chance. You know, fighting-wise. And, yeah, I'll give her hardness. Alright. So, what do I want to do? I want to make her a little physical, because, like I said, her main drawback is she has no real damaging energy. So, if trying to even raise her EP a little bit, kind of not worth it, really, to be all honest with you. But, yeah, I like that idea better. So that's why I really wouldn't, despite her being focused, I really wouldn't go that route. Now, look at Professor X. Oh, boy, this guy is nuts. Look at how stupid powerful he is. Yeah, that is that's pretty good. That's a lot of power right there and a lot of destruction. That's also very, very tough. That's radial, and that'll hurt like hell. He has 825 energy and 688 health. That's, ugh. Yeah, this is just absurd. Just absurd. And look at this! You're gonna see why. Professor X is just, oh, he's overpowered in this area. Very overpowered. I think you guys will like it. I'm going to use Emma Frost probably a little bit. To start, I have to use all three of them because I have to show you how powerful Jean Grey is now. As if she wasn't powerful enough before. Well, wait till now.
Okay.
The cool thing about this area is just how freaky it is. You know, everything is translucent. You can see right through stuff. The fact that this is all in an image of mine. This is just Oh, man. You know, I like the music. Music's actually pretty cool. So far, the thing's lying to me a bunch. And hopefully I won't fall into oblivion. Oh, here we go. Switch. Then open that door. Now, the enemies that come up here are all gonna be spectral. Doesn't mean you can't hit them, but it does mean they can be pains in the asses. And I'm missing something. I have to go up here, apparently. This spectral area, this astral plane is a bit of a maze. I learned. Thank God you have a Jean Grey, who can fly. Oh, derp. I don't think you can fly here. Either that or I didn't put anything into Jean Grey's flying ability, which I could have sworn I did. Matter of fact, let's solve this right now. Let's solve this mystery, shall we? I'm going to say it was Professor Plum in the ballroom with the revolver. Now, she has flight, so yeah, you can't fly here. For fear of breaking the level, I guess. I have no idea. And here you get to meet your first real enemies.
Professor, what are those creatures?
I'm not certain, but apparently they mean us harm.
Good. I'm in the mood for a fight.
So let's give him some punishment. Yeah, Jean Grey's doing 200 damage now. That wasn't a figment of your imagination. That's not because she's powerful of her powerful second abilities. That is legit. Once again, Jean Grey, most powerful attacker in the game. Hands down, bar none.
Yes.
And Emma Frost apparently got the snot beat out of her, even when I was controlling her. So, Let's see what she brings to the table. Do fear to start. That'll make everybody run around like cowards. She does pretty decent damage. As you see, I mean, she's not as powerful, but she is decent.
Combo!
And of course, being able to inflict fear on a lot of people is pretty awesome. I like the music, though, the fighting music. Just, I don't know why, I just like it. It's catchy. It's very catchy. But so far, I'm pretty impressed with Fear. I've never used it before. Well, Terror, I guess. You could say. But Emma Frost is a very good crowd control ally, but other than that, she kind of leaves a little bit to be desired, in my opinion. I'm gonna go down here, get this. Challenge for Jean Grey. Nice. I still gotta check to see if, because I'm very behind on editing these things.
Combo!
You know, because I just really haven't had the time. I've been more focused on, you know, recording.
Combo!
I'm more concerned about recording stuff than I am about editing, because I have time to edit it. Actually, what I've been doing when I've been on the internship is I would leave my computer home and just have it render a vid. Because I'm at work, you know, for 7 hours. Oh, jeez.
I believe I won that round.
That didn't seem to have a point.
Okay.
Well, let's show you Professor X, the big gun. Oh, man, this ought to be awesome. What I've been doing, though, is I would leave my computer up. And there's a look at Emma Frost, by the way. And the chess piece in the background, naturally. Because she's a white queen. Anyway, again, reason is because I can, you know, use the time, have my computer just upload stuff while I'm away and render a vid completely and, you know, make the vid on Pinnacle. So it has its uses. And here's how powerful Professor X is. He's slow as Rogue and Colossus in this regard. But yeah, he hits for ungodly amounts of damage. So yeah, overpowered is overpowered, and he did 741 there. So in all honesty,
sleep well.
I really wouldn't consider doing anything other than physical, regular melee attacks with him. Because you don't have the guarantee, they actually might do less damage. So really, you just have to like how powerful Professor X is. They made him so overpowered. He's level 40, obviously, so that kind of explains it right then and there. Look at that, one hit KO. Well, you know what the saying is, that new person used, the possibilities are endless? Yeah. The possibilities are truly endless here. And this is going the wrong way, isn't it? Oh yeah, it definitely is. Let's say it's a little bit of a maze, because it all looks the same, you know? You can get turned around super easy. Here's that radial attack, by the way. Pretty powerful. You know what? I'm too lazy. You never have to worry about Professor X being a liability here. He's just too powerful. He'll overpower enemies in ways that you never would imagine, as you're noticing. I mean, yeah, just... If you're ever in a bind, use Professor X. I already went this way. Jeez. Like I said, this happens a lot. I get lost. Then again, I have very bad sense of direction to begin with. Imagine if I tried blind LPing a game like this. I would be lost so often. I think it would drive me bonkers. $860 again. And obviously there's no need to really get any health packs because you're never in urgent need. Because, well, it takes a lot to get Xavier down there to that, to a level where he needs a health pack. Just look what it is right now. That's just unreal. 849 in two swings. If you see numbers like that that go up super fast, that doesn't necessarily mean you did 840 damage that one. Ah, yes!
I'm going to scout ahead.
Got it.
Forty Warrior, you are the biggest retard known to man. There, I said it. Jeez, I see my army men self has gotten the best of me in this playthrough. So we're at 23 minutes. I'm gonna stop it here. Next time, I won't be borderline retarded. So see you guys then. 40 Warrior, signing off. I am under attack apparently, but now I'm not. Ha!